see everybody. It seemed like everybody had a good Christmas and New Year's and new retirement and everything. So, but I do want to start out. Do we have anybody we don't want to add to our prayer list? Any prayer requests or praise reports? And I guess we all made it to another year. And we'll talk about that. A friend of ours, Miss Shelley, she's got a couple different cancers and stuff going on and treatments and that kind of thing. And she's hadn't been feeling real good. And I think just got over COVID on top of it. So her body ain't up to snuff to begin with and having a hard time getting over that. So y'all please keep her in your prayers. Is there anybody else that we'd like to mention or bring forward? Anybody? Definitely continue to pray for her. If y'all will, let's begin in a word of prayer. Dear Father, we want to thank you so much for the opportunity to get to come here this morning as to Sunday school and to church, and Lord, to read your word and to raise up your name above all names. Lord, we thank you. We know there's keeping our mind that there's so many people around this world that don't get to do what we're doing right here, right now. And Lord, we ask you to be with this all the Sunday school classes. Please be with the pastor as he brings your message to us here in just a little while. Lord, we ask you to be with all those that were mentioned here in this class this morning, and then we'll be brought up here today. Lord, we just lift them up in prayer. Lord, we ask you for comfort and peace for each and every one of you. Lord, just be with us today. Let us have a good day in you today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Again, good morning, everybody. We hadn't had Sunday school class in a couple weeks, so here we are at the beginning of a new year, 2023. Last year really seemed to fly by real quick. I mean, it didn't seem like 22 was here anytime. And I always heard, you know, the older you get, the faster the time seems to go by. And they seem to be a good bit of truth to that. It seems like it wasn't, but just, you know, a few days ago, we was trying to figure out how to pronounce COVID. And here we are 2-3 years later, and it's passed by. There's been a lot of change in this last year for everybody, every family. We've had those that have passed away, and we've had those new ones that have been born to the family, to church family and friends, and there's been those that were lost that called on the name of Jesus, and now they found. There's just been a lot of change that's gone over, and 2022, it's come and it's gone. And for better, for worse, different people have different recollections of last year, but we need to remember that no matter how we remember 2022, what went on, God brought us through that. He brought us through it, and here we are, sitting in 2023, and He did that for a reason. We ain't here just because he ain't figured out what to do with us yet. That ain't how it works. We're here for a purpose. And if we're still here, that means God has got a plan for us. And he's got a plan, and we're part of it. And we need to be thinking about what our part is in God's plan. Looking back and remembering 2022, or any other time, any other year, that's one staying in 2022 or staying in the past. That's something totally different. And I'm probably as guilty as anybody, and I can't stand it. But back in my day, and all this, well, we ain't in that day. We're not. Pull up to says, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? Excuse me. I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. So he's trying to tell us we need to look ahead. We don't need to look back. We don't need to look back at 2022. Whatever God had for us in 2022, it's done. We need to look forward to what God has got in store for us. And as Christians, we need to be excited about what God has got in store for us. We need to look forward to it. We've talked before about God's plan for us and our lives, and I'm sure there's many times that I know, me speaking for myself, and I don't think I'm the Lone Ranger on all this, we say, I just don't know what God's plan is for my life. I don't know what he wants this next step to be. I don't know which direction to go. I don't know how I'm supposed to do this, where I'm supposed to head. And we do it, and we kind of, I'm just lost, I don't know. And we kind of sad about it, and we kind of poochy-lipped about it. But we need to ask, have we asked God about it? Have we talked to God about it? Or did we just sit here and be lost about it? And there's been plenty of times it was like, I don't know what I need to do. And then I'm like, well, I really ain't prayed about it like I should have had. Maybe I need to talk to God about that thing that's bothering me so much, and it's got me down. And then I got, maybe it ain't near as big a secret as I thought it was. Maybe God's wanting to talk with me about it, but he's giving me opportunity to go to him and say, Lord, I need your help. I need a little clarity with this, because it's what I think is just scared me to pieces. And, you know, or I don't know which way to turn. Lord, I need some direction. And Moses died with it, like, all right, now that you're ready to listen. And a lot of times you look back and he has shown us things. He's shown us direction. But we was too busy walking around like this right here with our head down and our lip pooched out to see what he's trying to show us. And then you look back, or I do, and you look back and like, man, I sure could have saved myself a bunch of grief if I'd have turned to God a lot sooner instead of sitting here and fretting and worrying about all of this. And then I just feel silly because I done it. And I had the resource, and I didn't use it. My resource was God's word, and my resource was a conversation with God. A God that's sitting there waiting to help me and give me direction and steer me and turn me. Or maybe the answer might be, I know you want to know about this,
wait. He loves wait with me anyway. That's his favorite answer with me is wait. And I can't stand wait. It drives me nuts. But that's the answer I get. But it's an answer, and I got it from God, so I'm good with it. I don't really enjoy it, but I'm good with it. We need to realize that instead of fretting about this stuff, and, you know, we got a whole new year. We don't know what's going to happen in this year. We don't have a clue. But instead of worrying about it and walking around looking with our head down, we're children of God. We're children of the Almighty God. We need to hold our head up. Yes, we need to swell up a little bit. And we're supposed to be representing Jesus Christ down here on this earth. And we're supposed to be bringing people into the fold. Well, if they got a bunch of Christians walking around worried to death with their head down and their lip pooched out, that don't make them want to be some of us. I mean, who would want to be? That looks like they're scared to death. They worried about everything that comes up. Why would I want to hook up with them folks right there? I couldn't blame them. But they're like, I'm scared to death about this new world. But man, that fella I work with, that church-going guy that always talking about Jesus, he don't seem so worried about it. He's got concerns like the rest of us, but he's got a peace about him. And when we can show that peace that only comes through Jesus Christ, when we can show that peace to the world, that's an icebreaker. That's a, man, I'd like to have some of what that guy right there's got. Maybe I'll talk to him during lunch. You know, he sits right there and he tries to talk to me and I brush him off, but maybe I'll listen to him a little bit. That's what God can do. But he's got to have us to do it. And we've got to realize that the world is looking at us during this new. Show has shown us as horrible as 2022 may have been, and I don't know, some people had great years, some people didn't, as whatever it might have been, we need to know that God brought us through that. It was tough, it was hard, it was rough. Ain't nothing in here promise you anything different. But he brought you through it. And here you are. He even said that he'd make a way in the wilderness and make rivers in the desert. And that means he's going to do things in your life that you can't dream of. Amazing things that you don't even think possible. And chances are, most of y'all, he's probably done some things in your life already that you never would have dreamed possible. Guys in here, ladies, ain't no world that woman should have married you, but made it happen. There's you a mirror out there. I'm trying to keep. I can say 2 Corinthians 4 and 16. A far more exceeding and external weight of glory. Even though these old bodies are of ours, they're getting older, and they seem to make a lot more noises than they used to in the morning. And David went smiling when I talked about them extra noises. But we all got our issues, and we all got things that we go through. But our spirit is renewed daily. And I'm going to talk more about that in a minute. But the troubles that we have, the concerns that we have, they're short-term. They're short-term issues, but the glory of God is forever. And even if we have troubles that last for a lifetime down here on earth, they're just the blink of an eye compared to our time in paradise. It's gonna be nothing. In the book of Lamentations, it said, chapter 3, verse 22, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassion fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore, I hope in him. And there again, it says, new morning. Every morning. God's grace, by God's grace, yesterday wasn't our last day. He gave us another day. At work, of course, they always ain't going. It's going. There's a lot of wake up this morning. We bless. Is my portion. The Lord is all you need to get through this day. He's going to give us what we need for this day. He's going to give us what we need in this new year. This 2023, he's going to give us what we need to get through this. He will provide for his people. I've got a preacher friend of mine. His name's Tommy Taylor. And he says, if you have God, all the rest will fall into place. And that rings in my head. That's where you start. If you have God in your heart, everything's going to fall into place. You might not like it. You might not enjoy it. You might not think it's all that great. But it's going to fall into place. It's going to fall into God's place. Exactly where he wants it and how he wants it. So the Lord has given us a new year to be here. And I know I like to ask questions that we really need to ask ourselves this question. What are we going to do with this new year that God gave us? Don't worry about what you did in 2022. What are you going to do in 2023? God has blessed you to be here on this earth with a new year. And it's not one of those things that, you know, you got to spit it out right at the stroke of midnight and declare exactly what you're going to do. But we do need to talk to God about it. Lord, what do you do? What direction do you want? Not one thing that you got off. After when you accepted Christ, all that had to go. 2022 needs to go. We're going to put on our new self, our new Christian self. Well, what's she going to use that new with new opportunities that God has given us? It says that we are renewed in knowledge. You learned things last year. God taught you things last year. And you're going to use those things that God taught you last year in this new year. Don't know what it is? He'll show you what it's going to be. You wonder, well, what did I learn? You might learn something you ain't even figured out you learned yet. But it'll show it. It'll show up when God puts something in front of you and you're like, man, I went through that. Maybe you learned it so you could help somebody else in this coming year. Maybe we use those things to grow closer to God. And I put this in, if you choose, in 2 Corinthians 5:17, it says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new, and all things are of God, who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and hath given us the ministry of reconciliation, to wit, that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation. We're going to leave 2022 behind us. Ain't changed 2020. It gone. And it. But like we said, just like we left our old selves behind, you can't change the stuff that you did. But you can move forward. You can grow as a Christian. We can grow during 2023. We can grow closer to God. We've been given a new year. Adventures. Be excited about that. We need to do that. And if you know where to start, all right, I got a new year. I'm going to make a new start. What do I do? I don't know what the plan is. Place you can start. And this is one you've all heard times, but where to start? Start right. In the name of the Holy Ghost. Them to observe whatsoever I have come to you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. If you don't know what to do, where to go, tell somebody about Jesus. Just start right there. Tell somebody what Jesus has done for you. You start right there. Not sure what to do, where to go, how to do this 2023, go tell somebody about Jesus. You start right there. And God will, the Holy Spirit will lead you and guide you and tell you how far to go, which direction to head. But you start off by telling somebody about Jesus. The Lord has blessed us with a new year and a work to do in this new year. Tell the world about me and I'll be there with you. That's what we just read. He gave us a work to do, but he gave us a promise that went along with it. You do your work, and he promised he'd be right there with us while we do it. I pray that God blesses each and every family here this coming year. And I pray he blesses this church and this church family. And I got one more thing I want to read, and it kind of goes along with some of the stuff that we were reading earlier. about God as our portion and how our mercies are, God's mercies are renewed daily. And I mentioned this, I copied this off a Facebook post from a guy that I've mentioned in here before named Ricky Atkinson. And I thought it was one of those copy and paste things. And I very seldom read those, and I never forward them to anybody like they want me to. But there's something told me to read it, and it was one of those, it was like, I'm glad I did. I'm glad I did. Ricky is a really good guy. He's an award-winning gospel singer, and we were blessed to be with him on several occasions. He would come by our old church every now and then, and just on his way passing through to different singing venues he was headed to, and he'd just stop in and sing for us, and it was great. So that's what he did. But in that little moment of being real honest and sharing with people, he shared a text message that he got from a friend. And I like to read it every now and then. And I want to share it with you. And it says, it's very short, but it's one of them like, man, that's pretty good. It says, God's grace provides me with what I need every day. I find myself not struggling with today's problem, but worried about what will come tomorrow or the next day or the next day. And then it occurs to me that the reason I worry so much about tomorrow is because God hasn't given me tomorrow's grace yet. I've been straining my faith trying to live today off tomorrow's grace. So remember to take this one day at a time. God will give us new grace each day going forward. And I read that and I was like, and I read these verses like we read today, and it's like, you renew daily. Don't worry about tomorrow. I'll handle tomorrow for you. Tomorrow. I'll give you tomorrow's grace tomorrow. I'm giving you today's grace for the things that you have to deal with today. And on down the page, there was another quote. And it says this. It says, I do not at all understand the mystery of grace, only that it meets us where we are, but does not leave us where it found us. Man, that's pretty good. And when I start getting kind of worked up and worrying about tomorrow, I try to pull this up and read it. And it kind of gets me back where I need to be. God gave me the grace and His mercies for today. Let me just worry about today. And God promised me that He'd give me those mercies and that grace for tomorrow. And if I don't act like if I don't believe Him and I don't act like I believe Him, how good of a Christian am I being? And it kind of puts me back where I need to be. So we've got this new year coming up. We ain't got a clue what's fixing to happen this year. But let's use the grace that God gave us and the mercies that God gave us for today. Let's work on being a better Christian today. God's going to take care of us tomorrow. I believe it with everything I got. He's either going to take care of me down here, or He's going to take care of me up there in glory. And He'll give me the mercy and the grace I need tomorrow. I'll worry about that tomorrow. If y'all will, please bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you so much for blessing us with a new year, new opportunities, new adventures that you're going to bring us all through. Lord, we thank you for watching over us during 2022. But Lord, we know it's behind us. Lord, help us to be better Christians in 2023 than we were last year. Lord, help us to be better Christians today than we were yesterday. Lord, we thank you so much for your word that we can go to for comfort, for peace, for direction, for guidance, and anything else that you see fit that we need. Lord, help us to be good representatives of you down here on earth. Lord, we thank you for this time to get to come together. Lord, we ask you to be with the pastor as he brings the message here in a few minutes. Lord, help us to open our hearts and our minds and just take in everything that he tells us. We ask all this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.